Hey guys, what's up? It's Christine Seal, the High Level Queen, and in this video, I'm going to show you how to do a speed test on your website or funnel and what you should expect in terms of performance and what you should shoot for. So let's get started. So for those of you guys who don't know, we actually have a free Facebook group called Marketing Agency Automation Secrets, where we give away hundreds of dollars in free trainings every single week to our members. So click the link below to go check that out. So first, I'm going to talk to you about why website and funnel speed are important. And secondly, I'm going to talk to you about what you can do to test them and then how you can fix the issues. So first of all, why is site speed important? Guys, site speed impacts how much money you're going to make, okay? Because studies have shown that the slower your website speed is, the lower your conversions are, the lower your sales are, and the higher your bounce rate is. Also, it is going to, if you have a slow website, negatively impact your SEO with Google. So if you're trying to get ranked on the first page, it has got to be lightning fast, okay? It's really important to provide a good user experience, and that's something that's super important to Google. So if you want to learn more about that, you can check out the Cloudflare page here. But basically, the issues that you're going to come across are the web host and the web host speed limitations, as well as the images that you're uploading and any kind of scripts, JavaScripts or anything really heavy or bloated, as you say in the programming world, that might negatively impact your speed. So with that being said, one of the free tools that you can use to check your website speed performance is called GTmetrix. This is going to work regardless of your website host, but if you are looking for web host options, a really good one is called Gohighlevel, and you can actually get a link to a free trial in the description below, but you can host unlimited websites. You can have WordPress hosting. You can host funnels as well as memberships. So it's a really good option. And again, you can get a free trial using the link below. So what I'm going to do is I am going to copy my website link here, and then I'm just going to paste it in like this. And then I'm going to click on test your site. Okay, so it is going to test it in Vancouver, Canada. And this is just for your reference so that you know how long everything took. Okay, so this is actually a funnel that was created for my upcoming mastermind, February 5 to 7. In Dallas, Texas, where we are going to automate and scale and help people to get their time back in their agencies. So it is a very large website with a lot of text on it. I'm really interested to see these results here. So it looks like they gave me a D, and they said the performance was 65%, which just means it's the score that they gave me based on all the factors, and then a 75% based on the structure for optimal performance. And then largest contentful paint just means that that's how long it took to load the largest content element on your site. So this is actually a good score. That's why it's green. Total blocking time means how much time is blocked by scripts during the page loading process. So that's way too long, and that's probably because I have screen recording software on the website called Hotjar. And then this is how much layout shift is experienced as my page loads. So you can see here everything that they had an issue with and the things that I can fix to make the highest impact here. Okay, so then it's actually going to tell me what was wrong here. And if I click on the image, it's actually going to pull up the image. So that is one of my case study testimonials. My guess is they're all. Okay, so that's the big picture of me in the background, which is pretty unnecessary. Another case study testimonial. So something I can do to get a quick win right here
is I can actually downsize these images in Photoshop or some other image editor to help tremendously with the file size. And that's probably going to get me to a C at least, or maybe even a B, just by doing these things. Okay. Then here. All right. So a large DOM will increase memory usage, longer style, and produce costly layout reflow. So here I have a section that has like a lot in it. And if you can click on learn how to improve this, they'll actually tell you what to do to fix it. So go through this for your own website. And then I would just do the quick wins, honestly. I'm just going to worry about this right now because that's 4.61 megabytes. So this is going to be the quick win for me, is the image size, okay? So we want to reduce the image size. Keep in mind, most of your audience is probably on mobile. So you want to shoot for 650 pixels width. And you really don't need anything bigger than that unless it's some kind of background or something like this, okay? And I'm probably going to take this off because it doesn't add anything to the funnel. Something else you can do, you can minify CSS, JavaScript, and HTML. You can reduce redirects. You can enable compression, which I talked about a little bit already. You're going to want to, when you save your images and downsize them, also save them as a PNG. And then you can do other things like use a CDN, content distribution network, which actually Gohighlevel already does. Gohighlevel already does the minimization, the server response time improvements. They just did a huge upgrade to improve that. They also use a content distribution network, and they actually do optimize the images some when you upload them, but I think there's more that I can do on my end, okay? So that is how you check your website or funnel speed and why it's important and how to improve it. I hope this helps you guys. Make sure to grab your free trial using the link below. Don't forget to like and subscribe so you don't miss any future videos from me, and I'll see you next time.